we are going to develop applications. Which kind of applications we are going to develop basically? One is desktop applications. Desktop applications means nothing but standalone applications. Standalone, standalone applications means whatever the application, whatever the software you are installing in our system, only we can use. For example, if you install antivirus in your system, only you can use. Others cannot use. Okay, for like MS Office, VLC, Media Player, installable softwares, all those things are desktop applications. Second one is web applications. We are going to develop what? Web applications. And the third one is mobile applications. So by using Java, we are going to develop these kind of applications. This one is runs on server, like Facebook, Gmail, etc., which runs on web server. Mobile applications means what? Android. Okay. So by using Java, we are going to develop these three kinds of applications. Now my question is, to develop applications, mainly we are going to develop web applications. To develop web applications, do we have any other programming languages? This is what my question. To develop web applications or enterprise applications, do we have any other programming languages? Do we have?
Yes, like we do .NET.
Yeah, we have. Very good. Yeah, we have .NET is there. PHP is there. Like Ruby is there, Python is there, right? Scala is there. We are having n number of technologies, right? But why we are choosing only Java? And remember one thing: all these technologies, all these programming languages will provide security. Same everything, whatever the features it is giving, Java is giving the same features like platform independent everything. All these also will give, right? Even everything is platform independent, whatever the security providing by Java, these programming languages also will provide high level security, no issues. But why we are choosing again Java? That is what my question.
Maybe integration is good in this.
Okay, other than this, see, what are the upcoming technologies nowadays? What are the upcoming technologies? What are the upcoming technologies nowadays? Every day we are using Android, right?
Android.
We are using Hadoop, right? Hadoop and Big Data.
Big Data, right?
Right?
Yeah.
You heard about Pega, right? BPM tool. Just drag and drop. And you heard about Selenium, right? Testing. Yeah. All these are upcoming technologies. Okay. Now, if you observe one common thing here, all these upcoming technologies are developed using Java only. Okay. All the upcoming technologies are developed using Java. So, if you learn Java, we can migrate to any new technology very easily. That's why we are choosing Java. So, after working 2 years or 3 years on Java environment, you can migrate easily. Like if you are working on Salesforce, cloud computing, anything, AWS, web services, data science, Hadoop and Big Data, everything, all the upcoming technologies are developed using Java only. If you learn Java, we can migrate to any new technology very easily. That is what the reason. Okay. All the
upcoming
all the upcoming are developed using Java. Okay. So if we learn Java, we can migrate to any new technology very easily. We can migrate to any new technology very easily. This is what the reason why we are choosing Java. Clear?
Okay.
Fine. And one more question I'm having here. You heard about core Java and advanced Java, right? I think you heard already. These things, okay? So, what does it mean? What is the use of core Java and what is the use of advanced Java? This is what my question. Really, In real-time environment, do we have any core Java and advanced Java?
No idea.
Remember one thing. In real-time environment, we don't have any core Java and advanced Java. Okay? We don't have core Java and advanced Java. Basic thing. Okay? In real-time, okay, we don't have any core Java. For in our academics, for our better understanding only, they have given this core Java and advanced Java. Okay? Like in our BTEC or in our institutes, they have given this core Java and advanced Java. But in real-time environment, we don't have any core and advanced. If you go to any organization, then they never say that, do you know advanced Java or do you know core Java? They won't say. Okay? Java is given by whom? Java is given by Sun Microsystems.
Okay. Yeah.
James Gosling, right? Yes, exactly. Java is given by James Gosling from the Sun Microsystems. Of course, now it is acquired by Oracle. They sold it for about. So previously, we are writing the exams like SCJP, Sun Certified Java Programmer. Now it is
right.
OCJP, Oracle Certified Java Programmer. Okay, that's a different issue. Now, what this James Gosling has given, he has not given any time Core Java and Advanced Java. He has given mainly three editions for us. Okay, what he has given? Mainly three editions for us. Okay, so
enterprise.
What are the three editions they have given? JSE. Previously they have given like this, J2SE, okay, J2EE, J2ME. Okay,
ME.
Why they have given two is in JDK 1.2 version they have given like this, J2SE, J2EE, J2ME. But after that we got different versions. We got 1.3, 1.4, 1.5, 1.6, 1.7, and current version is we are using is 1.8 and 1.9 also. Okay, now that's why the developers got confusion. What is the use of these two? Then what they did is they have removed these two and they have introduced new thing in JDK 1.5 version. They removed the two and they have given JSE, JEE, and JME. Okay, this JSE stands for Java Standard Edition. Java Standard Edition. Okay. Similarly, Java
Enterprise
Edition. Okay. And then Java Micro Edition. Not Mobile Edition. Micro Edition. They have given these three editions. By using JSE, we are going to call it as, sorry, by using JSE, we are going to develop stand alone applications, which are nothing but desktop applications. Previously, we discussed it, right? Desktop applications. And by using JEE, we are going to develop web applications. We are going to develop what? Web application. And then by using JME, Java Micro Edition, we are going to develop what? Mobile applications. We are going to develop what? Mobile applications. These three kinds of applications we are going to develop using Java. Clear till now? Why we are learning Java and what is the use of Java? Now, you need to remember one more thing. Mostly, we are going to develop web as well as enterprise applications in real-time environment. Okay, what we are going to develop? Web as well as enterprise applications. Enterprise applications means business-related applications like Amazon, Flipkart, Snapdeal, or else hospital-related applications, e-commerce websites. All those are enterprise applications. By using Java, we are going to develop web as well as enterprise applications. Okay, we are going to develop what? Web as well as enterprise. So to develop any kind of web application, web application or enterprise application, we need three layers. What we need? We need mainly three layers. What are the three layers we are having? In that, first one is presentation layer. First one is presentation layer. And the second one is business layer. And the third one is persistence layer. Okay, any kind of application, not only Java. Either you may take .NET, PHP, Python, anything, compulsory we need to follow these three layers. Okay, presentation layer, which is nothing but user interface, front end. For example, if you're you'll be daily working with like you'll be daily using Gmail and Facebook, right? You'll be using
right.
So if you want to work with for example, if you want to use Facebook, what you are going to do? First you need to register. Then you need to log in, right? So you are viewing something, you are giving your username, password, your email ID, your date of birth, you are giving something and you are clicking on submit, right? Whatever you are seeing everything that user interface is developed by using presentation layer. There we are going to use HTML, CSS and JavaScript. Okay, HTML. A number of front-end technologies, CI technologies are there. Basic things are HTML, CSS and JavaScript. We are going to call it as user interface. You can call it as user interface or else front-end technologies. You will be calling it as UI also. User interface.
UI.
Or else we can call it as front-end also. For the purpose of presentation, whatever you are seeing that is developed by using front-end technologies like HTML, CSS and JavaScript. We are having n number of UI technologies. Basic things are HTML, CSS and JavaScript. Okay. Nowadays we have AngularJS, we have ReactJS, a number of things. Okay.
Right.
Now, for the purpose of business layer, here we are using Java environment. For example, if you are a .NET developer, you are going to use .NET. If you are developing using PHP, you will be having PHP. Business layer. Here we are using Java for the purpose of business logic. And next one is persistence layer. We are going to call it as what? Database layer. So for every application, we need one database to store the data, right? Mainly we are going to store the data only by developing applications. If it is a normal school website, we are going to show the information of students. If it is a college, we are going to show the information of students, faculties, everything. Means we need one database to store the data, right? Here also we can use MySQL database or else Oracle database. We are having different kinds of databases. Okay. Okay. So to develop any kind of application, we are going to work with these three layers compulsorily: presentation layer, business layer, and persistence layer. Okay. This is what our introduction. Now, basically, I'm going to explain you how we are going to start our sessions. Basically, we'll start our sessions with JSE part, Java Standard Edition. Initially, we'll be calling it as what? Core Java.
Okay. Right.
We'll be calling it as Core Java. So we'll start our sessions with Core Java. And from initial sessions onwards, I'm going to compare our Java with C language. So if you have idea on C language, then it would be very, otherwise, we'll treat it as new language. If you have idea in C language, then I'll compare and explain. If you don't have idea, then I will treat it as a new language and I'll explain each and every concept newly. Okay. Mostly we are going to discuss everything practically. Okay. Just we'll take one concept and just for 5 to 10 minutes, we are going to discuss about theory part and directly we'll be working on Eclipse IDE. Eclipse is one of the environment like IDE. It is going to, we'll be having n number of advantages. Automatically code will be generated, everything. I'll explain you later those things. Okay.
Okay.
So initially I'm going to start our sessions with Core Java. Once the Core Java part is completed, we'll be having JEE part, which is nothing but advanced Java we'll be coding. Here we'll be having three things: JDBC, servlets, and JSP. JDBC, servlets, and JSP. JDBC stands for what here? Java database connectivity. Means how we are going to communicate our Java application with database. But
right.
Before communicating our application with database, you need to know what is a database and how we are going to write the queries. We need to know, right? So before JDBC, I'll take classes on MySQL database for 1 or 2 days. Mostly I'll take 2 to 3 hours. Within one day, we'll complete MySQL database. In this MySQL database, I'm going to explain you how to create a database, how to create a table, how to create a table, insert data, how to update the data, how to delete the data, how to read the data, and we'll be having some joins. We'll be having different concepts. So everything we'll be discussing about MySQL database. Okay, clear? Once MySQL part is completed, then we'll go for JDBC. Then you can understand very easily about Java database connectivity. Okay, then what I said, after JDBC, we'll be having what? Servlets and JSP. Okay, so by using servlets and JSP, we are going to develop web applications. But to develop any web application, you need to have somewhat good knowledge on HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. So before servlets and JSP, I'm going to take like 3 to 4 sessions on HTML. So for a Java developer, what you need, everything I'll explain here. HTML, and then CSS, and then JavaScript. By using JavaScript, we are going to perform validations. Validations mean, for example, if you are applying for any online form or any online exam, for example, you are applying for passport, you have given all the values. Whenever you are clicking on submit, sometimes it will be asking like, please enter your father name, or please enter your mother name, or please enter valid date of birth. Some fields you may miss, right? Some fields,
right?
So it will be asking like, please enter your age. So these validations we are going to perform by using JavaScript on front end part. Okay. So if anyone asks you the difference between Java and JavaScript, by using Java we are going to write business logic. By using JavaScript we are going to perform client side validations, front end validations. Clear? JavaScript is applied only for user interface. Java is applied for business logic. Okay. That is the difference between JavaScript and Java. Okay. Once the classes of HTML, CSS, and JavaScript is completed, then we'll go for servlets and JSP. By using servlets and JSP, what we are going to perform here? We are going to develop web applications. We are going to develop web applications. Okay. Fine. Now we have n number of limitations, and here we are going to work with Apache Tomcat server. To develop our web applications, we need one server, right? Here, for the purpose of server, we are going to use Apache Tomcat. What we are going to use? Apache Tomcat server we are going to use. Okay. And we are going to work with Eclipse IDE. One more thing. Okay. So here, one thing what you need to remember is we are having n number of limitations in JDBC. We are having some limitations. Okay. So we are having limitations in JDBC. Limitations in JDBC. To overcome the limitations of JDBC, they introduced the concept called Hibernate. Okay. Hibernate is a framework. Okay. Fine. Once the advanced Java part is completed, then we'll go for Hibernate and Spring framework. Okay. We are having limitations in JDBC. That's why we are going for Hibernate framework. Just Hibernate means it is an ORM tool which is used to communicate our application with database. Nothing more than that. Instead of JDBC, we are going to work with Hibernate framework. Clear? Then, once it is completed, then we'll go over sessions with Spring framework, one of the most important framework. Before Spring framework, we are having a framework called Struts. We are having n number of limitations in Struts framework. That's why we are going for Spring framework. So again, by using Spring framework, we can develop any kind of applications. Like we can develop standalone applications, web applications, mobile applications. And the biggest advantage of Spring is we can integrate with any framework very easily. Okay. And here we'll be having some modules. In Spring framework, we are having some modules. What are the modules we are having? Basically, we'll start our session with Spring IOC. Then we'll be having Spring JDBC. You are going to work mostly on Spring framework and Hibernate framework, and then RESTful web services. Okay. Yeah. But in order to understand these things, you need to know the limitations of servlets and JSP, all those things. Okay. Then right. Spring ORM. Spring ORM is here. We are going to integrate Spring with Hibernate. We are going to integrate Spring with Hibernate. And one more is Spring AOP. Spring AOP. Okay. Once these modules are completed, you will be having some more concepts in Spring only. That is Spring security. How we are going to provide our security for our application by using Spring. Okay. And then we are having one more concept called Spring Transaction Management.
Okay.
Transaction. These are the modules of Spring actually. Okay. And one more module we are having, that is Spring Batch Processing. And actually, we are learning all these things, but based on the specific requirement we are going to use. Everything we are not going to use in our applications. Based on the requirement only, we are going to work. Okay. These are the modules we are having in Spring. Just we need to know what is the use of these modules. But what you need to remember here is all these things, if you want to work with these things, we'll be having one configuration file, one XML file or annotations. You'll be having two approaches. Any of the one approach we are going to use. But instead of this, they have introduced a new concept. So we are having some limitations in Spring framework. That's why again Spring people has introduced a new thing called Spring Boot, one of the most important concepts. Even we are going to integrate our Spring application with RESTful web services by using Spring Boot only. Okay. So we are going to work with this. Here we are having more limitations in Spring framework. Okay. To overcome the limitations of Spring framework, they have introduced a concept called Spring Boot. Okay. Even here only we are going to discuss about RESTful web services, RESTful API. Okay. RESTful web services. These are the things we are going to discuss. Once it is completed, here only we are going to work with Maven. We are having some real-time tools. tools. Why? Because in order to work with any framework or any, for example, if you are having some experience, compulsory you should have this knowledge on these tools. This one of the tools is, first one is Maven. Okay, in order to add, actually whenever we are working with the hybrid framework or Spring framework, we need to add some jar files. Okay, every time we need to add jar files. Instead of adding those jar files, simply we'll be going for Maven tool. We'll be adding the dependencies in form.xml. We'll be having one XML file, form.xml. That XML file, we are going to add the dependencies. Okay. Similarly, to perform some unit test cases, we are going to use JUnit. Okay. Then, for the purpose of debugging, we are going to use Log4j. Okay. Finally, we are going to work with one repository, either SVN or GitHub. Either SVN or GitHub. These are the tools mostly we are going to work. Okay. So initially we'll start our session with introduction, like Java installation and how we are going to work. Basically, just I'll explain two or three examples in Notepad, then directly we'll be going with Eclipse IDE. Okay. Initially we'll start with core Java. Then once it is completed, then we'll go for MySQL database. Then we'll go for JDBC. JDBC means how we are going to communicate our Java application with database. Once it is completed, then we'll go for HTML, CSS and JavaScript. Then solids and JSP. Nowadays we are not using mostly solids and JSP. Instead of JSP for the purpose of front end, again we are using AngularJS. That is a different concept. Okay. When it comes to Java part, we are having more number of limitations in JDBC. That's why we are going for Hibernate framework. Similarly, and one of the important framework is Spring framework. Mostly we are having these modules, most important modules. And 99% we are going to work with Spring MVC, Spring JDBC, and everything is important. Based on the client requirement, we are going to use these modules. We are not going to work with every module in a single application. Based on the client requirement or customer requirement, we are going to work with this specific module. But you should have very good knowledge on like Spring MVC, Spring Boot, and RESTful Web Services. If you are having experience, means compulsory should have knowledge on these tools also. Okay. So this is about our brief introduction.